Hello everyone, welcome to Students Mind. This is 16th of March and we will cover all the important current affairs of the day. First, let us see question for the day, which you have to answer in the comment section, and on weekend we will see answer of the previous day question. So here is the question. Nigha, which is a mobile application to curb election malpractices, has been launched by which state? So these are the options. Read the options very carefully and then answer it in the comment section. So let's begin the first question. Which of the following recently released Animal Protection Index? So World Animal Protection released this index, and under this index, India gained C grade. It assesses the animal welfare policies and legislation of 50 countries and ranks them from A, which is the highest score, to G, which is the lowest score, with 10 indicators. So India has been ranked as C, along with Mexico, Malaysia and France. Other countries, no countries were able to gain grade A. Focus here that no countries gained grade A. In grade B, there were countries like Austria, Denmark, Netherlands, Austria, Switzerland and United Kingdom. And in grade C, we have, along with India, Germany, Italy, Poland, Spain, New Zealand. And in grade G, we have Azerbaijan and Iran. Next question. Consider the following statements with reference to anti-defection law. The topic of anti-defection law is recently in news because several MLAs in Madhya Pradesh have resigned from Congress party and joined the BJP, that is Bharatiya Janata Party. So the topic is in news that the law shall apply on these MLAs or not. So let's see the statements. The 10th schedule was inserted in the constitution in 1985. By the 52nd Amendment Act. So this statement is correct. It was inserted in this year by the 52nd Amendment Act in the Constitution. And the decision on disqualification on ground of defection is referred to the chairman or speaker of such house. This part is correct. The question of defection is referred to either chairman or speaker of that house, and his decision is final. This is incorrect. And immune from judicial review? No. This is also incorrect, because earlier it used to be immune from judicial review and decision of speaker or chairman in this regard was final. But later Supreme Court gave a judgment that decisions of speaker or chairman is subject to judicial review and MLAs or MPs affected can be able to move directly to the Supreme Court. So here, first is right, but second is wrong. So here B is the right answer. And as I told, Supreme Court in 1992 allowed appeals against the presiding officer's decision in the High Court or Supreme Court. However, it held that there may not be any judicial intervention until presiding officer gives his order. So focus here that until presiding officer gives his order, Supreme Court or High Court cannot intervene. Next question. Consider the following statements about National Clean Air Program. It is supposed to be national framework for air quality management with a time bound reduction target. This is correct. And it will not be notified under the Environment Protection Act or any other act. This is also correct. That is why this clean air program is criticized, because it is not legally bound, or it is not legally binding and first of its kind effort in the country. And it was launched in January 2019. It aims to include 102 non-attainment cities across 23 states and union territories. What are those non-attainment cities? These cities are those cities which have been consistently showing poor air quality than national ambient air quality standards. And target, it said target to reduce 20-30% of particulate matter 2.5 and particulate matter 10 by 2017 and 2024. And CPCB will execute this nationwide program under Section 162 of Air Act. Next question. How much has the Central Board of State Bank of India approved to invest in Yes Bank as a part of RBI's Yes Bank Limited Reconstruction Scheme 2020? So it is 7,250 crore. SBI and seven other lenders have agreed to invest rupees 10,000 crore to revive Yes Bank, and SBI will buy 725 crore equity shares, each valuing rupees 10. So it will cost around 7,250 rupees. What is bull and bear markets? Focus here. The terms bull and bear market are used for stock market's performance. This is correct. A bear market is a market that is on rise and economically sound. Here it is incorrect. I have interchanged these options. A bear market is actually a market which is receding, which means that it is going down or slowing down, where values of stocks are decreasing, not increasing. So 2 is incorrect and 3 is also incorrect. You can remember by a trick that in bull market, a bull have a horn. So horn is always upward. So the prices of a stock here will go up, not down. And in bear market, it will go down. So here only first is correct, B is the right answer. That is, a bull market is a market that is on rise and is economically sound. Whereas a bear market is a market that is receding, where most stocks are declining in value. Next question. Ayushman Bharat provides health insurance of rupees 5 lakh per family per year. This was the previous day question. Next question. Consider the following statements about sepsis. It is a life-threatening organ dysfunction caused by body's immune system overreacting in response to an infection. This statement is correct. See, normally our immune system is very important to protect us from several infections, but sometimes it becomes dangerous. How? When it overreacts to some infections, and it can be triggered by a variety of pathogens, which may include virus, bacteria, fungi or parasites. This is also correct. So remember that sepsis can be caused by virus, bacteria, fungi and parasites. So here C is the right answer. And sepsis is a common cause of death from coronavirus. In addition, seasonal influenza, other viruses that are highly infectious such as coronavirus, Ebola, yellow fever viruses, dengue, swine flu or bird flu viruses can also cause sepsis. Sepsis is most common and most dangerous in older adults, pregnant women, children younger than 1, or people who have chronic conditions such as diabetes, kidney or lung diseases, cancer, or people who have weakened immune systems. Next question. Name the World Organization which has launched first global COVID action platform for private sector businesses fight against COVID-19 with the support of WHO and Wellcome Trust. So it is World Economic Forum, and under it will focus on galvanizing the global business community for collective action and protect people's livelihood and facilitate business continuity. Also mobilize cooperation and business support for COVID-19 response. Next question. Which of the following company has launched Digi Pivot? So it is Google India. Google India has started this initiative. The initiative is launched in association with Avatar and Indian School of Business. And it is a platform to build digital marketing skill set for women professionals in India. And the program aims to provide an opportunity for 200 women professionals to reskill themselves. So if you find the video useful, don't forget to like it, subscribe to the channel, answer the question in the comment section, and wait for the next video. Till then, stay safe and thanks a lot.